Okay, so if you're using Google Sheets and you have kind of a long list of data, a very easy way to extract information out of it is to use a pivot table. I already made one on this worksheet, and this is where we're going to end up. So you have the sales rep on the left, you have the ship mode up top, and then you have it by year. I've already filtered this year. We're going to do that at the end. And you can see how it's set up over here. So I'm going to delete this. So this list here I have, I think, is a good example of what makes good data for a pivot table. And what that means is that, one, it has headers, and the headers obviously pertain to the data that's underneath it. So the sales rep describes what's in this column. There are no breaks in this data. So if I scroll down, there's no blank lines, and it's so much data that you can't just look at it and get the information, right? Okay, so make sure that you've selected a cell within the table of data that you want. This spreadsheet that I have only has a table, so that's not hard to do. Then you go up to the menu, select data and pivot table. And that gives you a blank slate that you're going to work with. It will suggest different pivot tables. I'm going to use some artificial intelligence to kind of figure out what we want. Unless you have very simple data and you just want to have it summarized by one dimension, these aren't going to guess what you want because there's so many different combinations. But if you do just try one of these and click on it, it's going to build a table for you, which can be really helpful if you have simple needs, right? But just to show you how it's constructed, I'm going to take that off. And what we had said, we decided we wanted to do is we wanted to analyze it by sales rep first. And I imagine that going down the left-hand column. But this is where it's a little bit confusing, right? So you want it in this column, but you actually want each salesperson to be in a row. So that's why it says rows here. You want to add the sales rep for rows, even though it's going to be in a column. So you want each row, we're going to add, we want it to be a sales rep. And it's filled that portion out for me. So it's put them in an alphabetical order. It assumed that we wanted to sort by sales rep. Right now, we can't sort by anything else, so that's fine. And on the columns, you want the ship mode. And again, this is a little bit confusing, right? This is a row. It's going to be your row of headers. But it's going to be each column is going to have the data in it, so it's called columns. And let's add the ship mode. And you'll notice on each of these, it's asking if you want to show the totals or not. It's going to be a grand total for the sales rep and a grand total for the ship mode. Now in here, let's look at the count of sales. So I don't want to see the dollar amount. I want to see the number of sales. So for values, values is going to be what it shows you in the middle of your pivot table. It's the actual meat of the table. So you have your headers in here. Now you need to put something in the middle. Let's go to values and add. Our sales column is what had the dollar amounts in it. So let's add the sales. And it's summing them right now. I want to add each one of them as one. So one sale. So we're just going to do count. And we're most of the way there. So we have sales rep and we have a count by each ship mode. And the last thing we wanted to do is we wanted to look at it by year. And I'm envisioning those being on the left hand side here under each sales rep. So remember, this is called rows, even though it's a column. So let's go over to the rows. Let's add another column of rows, if you will. And we're going to make it the date. Now, this isn't what you want, right? We want it by year. But in order to do that, you had to add the dates. So it's a value in here. And now what you can do is right click on any of the dates and create a pivot data group and select year. This is going to summarize it by year because Google Sheets recognizes that those are dates and it can extract the year and summarize by just that. And let's say you're just looking for 2018. So let's go back to the right, scroll down to the filters. We're going to add a filter for the date. And this will be a little bit tricky how we're going to do this. So let's do a drop down. It said showing all items. We're going to select clear. And then we're going to type in 2018. Now we're going to hit select all. So what we're doing here is we're saying unselect everything, show no dates. But then if you type in 2018, it'll show only the 2018 dates that are in the original table. Now, if you click select all, it's going to select all that it's showing for 2018 and click OK. And then you have this filtered by 2018. And one last thing, let's say Phil left the company, so you want to take him out. Just add another filter. Go to sales rep. Right now it says showing all items, so we're going to come here and uncheck poor Phil because Phil's no longer with the company. Click OK. And there you are. Really easy to understand pivot table with just the data that you need. And if you want to change anything, this is always live, right? Just go back here and customize it however you want. So that's all. Taking a good solid list of data that has columns with consistent data types in it, no blanks. And we've created this pivot table that gave you the exact information that you wanted to see. So I hope that was helpful. If you like that video and you want to see others like it, please subscribe to my channel in the lower right-hand corner. Thanks.